I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am discussing about the control engineering. In the control engineering, we are focusing on the signal flow graph by using the Menzies gain formula. This is the diagram they have given it. In the diagram, first you have to mention the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next, you have to find out the first forward path here. You have to find out the first forward path. Forward path. Forward path. The arrow starts here and ends here. We call it the first forward path. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is the forward path. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It should be a forward path. It will be 1, G1, G2, G3, G4. Now I will consider that P1 is nothing but just multiply this one. G1, G2, G3, G4. And write the number in the box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next forward path. From here, it moves here and end here. This is the forward path. This is nothing but a loop. This is nothing but a closed loop. Now this is the forward path. Next forward path will be 1, 2, 5 and 6. 1, 2, 5 and 6. 1. This will be G5, G4, C of S. You can write R of S, C of S here if you want. Otherwise, no need. Next, P2 is nothing but G5, G4. In bracket, you can write the number 1, 2, 5, and 6. Now, K is equal to 2. There are two forward paths here. Apart from this, no other possibility exists in the diagram. Forward path. Next, we have to find out the loop. Individual loop. Loops. First loop, it starts here, it completes, it forms a complete circle. We call it the first loop. 3 and 4. This is G2, this is minus H1. I will consider P11 is nothing but minus G2 H1. Write the number in box 3, 4. Next loop will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, again 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, again 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. G1, G2, G3, G4, minus H2. P12 can be written as minus G1, G2, G3, G4, H2. In bracket, you can write 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Numbers, I am going to write in the bracket the number. Next possibility, loop, it starts here, it reaches here, again it completes. Next, 2, 5, 6, again it comes back to 2. 2, 5, 6. G5. G4, and this will be minus H2. P13 is nothing but minus G4, G5, H2. Number 2, 5, 6. The three possible individual loop. The three possible individual loop. Next, we are going to find out non-touching loop. For non-touching loop, I am going to find out non-touching loop. It is very easy to find out the non-touching loop by seeing the number. Non-touching loop, between the loops you have to find out. How to find out non-touching loop? 3-4. 3-4. Oh, there with 3 and 4 both are the number exist here. Therefore, the loops are touching here. Next, 3-4. 3-4. There is no 3 and there is no 4. This is called as a non-touching loop. नॉन टचिंग लूप। फर्स्ट डायग्राम दिस वे, 3 4 जी टू माइनस एच वन, आई विल कंसिडर दिस इज इन टू दिस पार्ट। टू फाइव सिक्स जी फाइव जी फोर माइनस एच टू, आई विल कंसिडर दिस वन इज ए पी टू वन। Multiply this two. The value for this one is, first value will be minus g2h1 into minus g2h1 into minus g4h5h2. It becomes what? G2 g4 h5 h1 sorry g5 h1 h2. This is nothing but non-touching loop. Next, you have to find out delta. Delta is nothing but 1 minus loop plus non-touching loop. Okay, now delta 1 minus individual loop. These are the individual loops. Because of minus, minus has become plus. Okay, I will write in the bracket completely. Minus g2 h1. Next, this part. Minus g2, sorry, g1, g2, g3, g4, h2. Minus g4. G5 H2 plus non-touching G2 G4 G5 H1 H2. Further, it can be written as delta is equal to 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1 G2 G3 G4 H2 plus G4 G5 H2 plus G2, G4, G5, H1, H2. This is the delta. Now, using the Mensen's formula, C of S by R of S, T is nothing but P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 divided by delta. Now, what is P1? P1 is nothing but, this is we call as a P1. P1. And this is P2. If there are 3 forward path, you have to write P3 into delta 3. 4 forward path, P4 into delta 4 you have to write. There are 2 forward path, therefore P1 delta 1, P2 delta 2 you have to write. In this way, you have to create the formula. Next, now we have to find out delta 1. We know P1. What is delta 1? We don't know. We have to find out delta 1. Delta 1 is nothing but 1 minus, now, individual loop. This you have to see. Whether this, only focus over the numbers. Okay, 3, 4, 3, 4 exist. It touches the loop. 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, everything touches the loop. 2, 5, 6, 2. Okay, 2, 2 is there, touches the loop. Therefore, delta is equal to 0 here, 1. Delta 2, 1 minus, next, 1 minus, you have to see the second loop. Now, second loop, 3, 4, 3, 4. 3, 4, 3, 4 doesn't exist here. Therefore, you have to write this value, plus G2, H1. Next, 2, 3, 4. 2 is there, 2 is there, touches the loop. 256, touches the loop. That's it. The possibility is only this one. I have written it. And substitute in the formula. Now, C of S by R of S is nothing but, what is delta 1? What is P1? P1 is, this is the P1. G1, G2, G3, G4. What is delta 1? 1. Delta 1 will be 1. Plus what is P2? P2 will be G5, G4 into 1 plus G2 H1 delta 2 value divided by delta. Delta is nothing but this term. 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1 G2 G3 G4 H2 plus G4 G5 H2 plus G2 G4 G5 H1 H2. Please complete the problem. I am Satish Gaidankar. Thank you very much.